Now let's talk about while loops. For loops are for situations where we know exactly how many times something's going to execute. There are situations where we don't know. And just as a little example, I'll create a class here, while fun. Okay, so I've created this little program, and let's say that I'm going to get some information from the user. I'm going to say import java util.scanner so I can get information from the user, and then I'm going to build a scanner. So scanner, not a canner, scanner in equals new scanner system.in. Okay, and then I'm going to create variable to store the information that I'm going to read in order to be able to check this information. And let's say that we're asking the user for, oh, I don't know, let's say age. Okay, that example's getting kind of tired. But something that can't be negative. So let's say that we ask them for their height. Okay, so we'll create an integer, or actually let's do a double. Let's get tricky here. Let's create a double called height, since we can, you know, some of us will take every half inch we can get. And I'll just set that equal to 0.0 to begin with. So I'm going to read in this height. Get the user height. And so system.out.println and say, how tall are you in inches? And then I'm going to read in that height by saying height equals in dot next. And what type of information are we reading in? Well, it's a double, so I'm going to read in the next double. Okay, so we've got that height. Now I want to check to see whether that height is a valid height or not. So I can say if height is less than 0. Didn't we already do an example like this? How sad is that? I'm already reusing examples. If the height is less than 0, then we'll say system.out.println that is not a valid height. So I'll save this and run it. And as long as I enter a positive number, 40, it's fine. But as soon as I enter a negative number, negative 5, it will say that is not a valid height. And that makes sense because height was a negative 5 and that is less than 0. All right. So let me make a little comment here. I need to be better about my commenting. Check to see if height is valid. Okay. And I could even say this. I could say try again and then give them another opportunity. So height equals in dot next double. The problem is you can never underestimate the lack of intelligence of your users. Now that's kind of harsh. I shouldn't say that, because what really happens is a lot of times we know what we want the input to be, but it's kind of confusing for the user coming into it for the first time. If you want an interesting experience, stand by somebody who's using your program and watch them use it, and you'll see you're tend to be saying, no, don't do that. No, don't click there. It's kind of an interesting experience. So, but I say this time, I say negative 5, well, that's not a valid height, try again. What do you mean? Negative 5 again, and then it goes through. Because we're only doing one check here, so maybe I need to do another if statement after they've done it again. So now if height is 0.0. But what happens if they enter it wrong a third time, or a fourth time, or a fifth time? There are some situations where I don't know how many times they're going to enter bad information or to do something. And these are what we call indefinite loops. It's not a definite number. So a good rule of thumb is whenever I have an if, I could put in a while instead. And that says while this condition is true, then keep doing this over and over and over and over and over again. All right, so let's try it. I say let's compile and run this, and I say negative 5, and it says that's not a valid height, try again. Well, if I enter negative 5 again, then again it will tell me that's not a valid height, try again, because it keeps testing it here whenever we hit the bottom of the loop. So now I'm here waiting for another double to be entered, so I'll enter in a negative 10, and we come right back up to the top of the loop and we say height still is less than 0, so we're going to print it out again. And we're going to keep doing this over and over and over again until we get a valid height. Well, now I enter 70 inches and the program goes on because we've gotten through that loop. And so this is a way that we commonly use a while loop to check for valid data. And whenever we see this situation where we want to, we're not exactly sure how many times we want to do something, then that tells us it's going to be a while or a do while. And then the test for whether we want it to be a while or a do while loop is, do we want to do it at least once? Do we want to print out that's not a valid height at least once? Well, the answer is no. Let's say they come through the first time and they enter a correct height, 60, the very first time through. We never want it to get to this statement. And so a while loop is what we call a precondition test. It's a precondition test because we test the condition first and then decide whether we're going to go into the loop or not. Whereas in a do while loop, we want to execute the code at least once and then do the check after the fact. So that would be a post-condition loop, a post-condition check. In fact, I hadn't planned on doing this, and maybe this would be a incredibly bad idea, but I can do the same thing let's say I want them to be able to enter their height multiple times. Well, I can do that by enclosing this in a loop and saying I want to do the following thing over and over and over again. So I'm going to take all this code and indent it because it's now part of my do loop. And the structure of a do loop goes like this. I say, here is what I want to do in the loop, down to this brace. Okay? After the brace closes for the do loop, I put a while, and I'm going to do this whole thing while a certain condition is true. And so if I just put a little Boolean variable called do again and set equal to true, then I could make my test while do again equals true, or since it holds the true, we can just say while do again, then it will keep doing this. And so I can say, how tall are you? 50 inches. Well, then it will ask me again, how tall are you? Because I hit the bottom of this loop. Now keep in mind, it's not telling me it's not a valid height. It's a perfectly valid height. And so it's just going to ask again. If we're asking for multiple heights, then we can do it in this type of a loop. So again, with a do while loop, the do comes first to indicate that this code is what's going to be done again and again and again down to this brace. And then after that do is done, then we put the while with the condition. And so we may have something like this. We may say, let's create a string for user input and set it equal to blank to begin with. and then say, we want to do all this stuff as long as the user doesn't want to quit. So let's do this. So assuming I got through this and it was a valid height, then I could say system.out.println and say valid height. Thank you. And then we can say system.out.println enter another. Well, let's do it this way. This is how we usually ask it. We say press Q to quit or any other key to continue. Okay, so that's what we're printing to the user. Well, we got to get that information read in. So into that input variable that I created, I'm going to say input equals in.nextLine to read in with a capital L, to read in their input. And then the decision I'm going to make is, we want to do this while what? Well, we've just set up the condition. As long as it's not a queue, then we want to do it again. Okay? So I'm going to say, as long as the input does not equal a queue. Well, there's not equal, there's not a not equals. I put a not out here in the front and say, as long as the input is not equals to a queue, that wasn't a really good way of saying that. As long as it's not the situation that input equals a queue, then we're going to do this again. And by the way, the while's kind of the odd one of the bunch, because on an if statement, we don't want a semicolon. On a while loop, we don't want a semicolon. If we put a semicolon here, then it will always print that is not a valid height, because we said the while loop ends there. But in a do while loop, we do want to tell Java that the while loop ends there. That is the end of the do while loop if we get there, but it won't get there unless we meet the condition, right? So as long as it's not a queue, then we'll ask for another height. Let's test this out. Okay, so how tall are you? 50. All right, and it says valid height, thank you. And then it says press Q to quit or any other key to continue, and then it just continues. Well, the problem here is back to our old friend of flushing the buffer. We asked for a double, and it read out the double, but now that enter stroke after the double. So I say 50, enter. The double is read out using this next double, but I still have an enter stroke sitting in the buffer. And so before I ask the user for more input, I need to flush the buffer. And I do that by saying in.nextLine, not reading it into anywhere, just reading everything out of the buffer. Let's try that now. So if I, compile and run that. How tall are you? 50. Then it will say valid height. Thank you. Press Q to quit or any other key to continue. Well, if I press Q, then the program ends. If I press any other key, high, then the program will continue again. And so we can use the do while loop for things like, we don't know how many times they're going to want to enter a height. So it's also an indefinite loop, but we want them to enter the height at least once. And so we put it in a do while loop, so it'll ask all this stuff, and then at the end, check the condition to see if we want to continue. Now, by the way, if we enter a lowercase q, 50, enter a lowercase q, it'll still continue, and that's because Java's case sensitive, so we'd probably want to put an equals ignore case there. And that way, if we enter a lowercase q, it'll quit the program still because it's ignoring the case. So those are two common uses of a while loop and a do while loop. And hopefully it wasn't confusing to put them together because they're two separate things. This one's checking to see if it's valid input. This one is checking to see whether they want to continue or not. All right. Okay. Spencer out.